Does the new layout of Cricut Design Space confuse you? Well, I'm Corinne Blackstone, and I'm here to help eliminate all of your confusion. We're going to show you where all of your features are, including flatten, attach, group, all the things, and how to use them and where to find them in the new Cricut Design Space. Be sure that you're subscribed here on YouTube. That way you don't miss out on any of the fun, crafty content we have coming. I'm here to help you learn how to use your Cricut and do it with pizzazz. So without further ado, let's get started.
So here in Design Space, they have changed some things and you may or may not see the changes. So for example, I am in the Design Space software, but I am in what they call the live software. So I'm just gonna grab an image, any image will do, it does not matter, but I wanna show you this. So this is like your original Design Space. So if your Design Space looks like this, you're likely in the live version as of September, which is when I'm filming this, 2025. You may not see this video until October. But if you see your Design Space, it looks like this, where you see you've all of your options up here at the very top of your screen, and then you have your layer panel, all that stuff, and then all of your layers options down here. But Design Space is doing some updates, and you can find those updates in their beta version if you're not seeing it in this. So to get to beta, it's very easy. Go to your profile, go under settings, and then under this general section, you'll see application experience. It's the fourth one from the top. And then you'll see live or beta. Now I'm gonna choose the beta. Now it's gonna tell me my application may restart, save all work before changing the application experience. No big deal, we're not worried about that. I'm gonna hit done and it's going to restart. Now that we're in beta, I have made my mouse bright and big so that you can see where we are pointing. So you're gonna notice that your beta looks quite a bit different. You're gonna notice your top panel, much less stuff on it, much different. Even if I select the cat, it's a lot different. Also down here, you're gonna notice, I'm gonna get rid of this little ad, but you'll notice that you don't have any of your combine options, your weld, your contour, slice, nothing like that down here. And now you have something called material colors. We'll address that in a minute, but it's literally the same thing as your color sync section. But let's go ahead and start with this kitty cat here. Now you're gonna say, I wanna put an offset on it, but there's no offset option. What you'll do is you're gonna go up here, you see this little blue blinking blob? You're gonna click on the little pen, and this is where you're gonna find so many of your tools that you are used to seeing right on the screen. Now, one reason I don't really like this is I don't wanna have to sit there and have extra clicks, less screen to work with, and all of that just to work with my design. So with this, you're taking up quite a bit of your screen. You're also having to click something else to access, just not my favorite. But here you have your position, which is where it's sitting on your screen. So you'll notice if I move it, that this position changes. And the X and Y axis is tied to the numbers here on the top and the side of your design space. The next thing you'll see is your rotate option, which you can always rotate using the little pull tab here on the side, but you can also rotate using these numbers if you prefer to do it that way. So there's lots of ways to use that, but there's where your rotate is. Now this right here is where you're gonna find the effects. So you're gonna have offset, your sticker set function, and your warp function. Now previously, warp did not work with images, but it does now. So I can make my cat kind of look like a hamster, which I think is hilarious. But there's lots of ways you can use the warp function, but it does work with Design Space images. I don't know for sure with others, I haven't tried it, but we can definitely give it a shot. So let's grab one of our images and see. This here is an image I just grabbed from anywhere. I don't remember, I think Creative Fabrica, but I'll make it smaller so we can see it since it's gonna reduce the size of our screen. Let's go to this and check our warp function. And yes, so you can use warp with images now, which is cool. So that's a new function. But if you wanna add an offset, just simply click offset and it brings up your offset option. And then you can see you can just apply. Now we're not gonna do this really to show you anything other than how to use your functions and where to find them. But now let's say, well, I wanna contour my offset, so I don't have any of the holes. Your contour can be found down here under all your combine options. So I can go to contour, hide all contours, and now my design is fully filled in. And if I wanna slice, you're gonna notice one thing that I think is missing that kind of bothers me. There's no select all anymore. Do you see that? No select all option. Now I did use that quite often, so I'm kind of not loving that that's not there. It's also not down here under all tools. But if you right click, you'll see still not an option. So from now on, you either have to select everything over in your layers panel by holding shift on your keyboard and clicking, or drawing the square around the items. Now, this is where you're going to see all of your options that you can use will be lit up. You're going to see you have slice, weld, unite, subtract, intersect, and exclude are options you can use. But because I have these two items selected, I can't use unflatten because they're not flattened. And I can't use contour because I have two items selected. But I can use things like weld, slice, you know, all those. So we'll slice it just so you can see kind of the function and it working. So you can see here I have my sliced out image and I have my two other images. Now, if I want to change its color, that's still up at the top and I can do that. And I can change the colors to whatever I want them to be. Now, where the material colors are is where your color sync is going to be. So if I wanted to make this cat the same color as the purple cat, I just drag it and drop it, and that's exactly the same. But now let's say, okay, we want to use print then cut. So I'm going to just go ahead and I'm going to go under where it says basic cut and change this to print then cut. Now you'll notice that it gets rid of those black lines. Those are just showing you where your machine's going to cut. If I want to take this and let's say I want to add an offset because I want to make this into a sticker, go under your pen, add your offset. Again, I'm just going to add whatever size and I'm going to go ahead and contour it to hide all of those little holes. Now, what you'll see here is if I select both items, I still don't have a flatten option. I only have unflatten. So you're thinking to yourself, well, that doesn't make any sense because under our layers panel, we don't have a flatten option either. So how am I supposed to flatten these objects together to create a sticker? You have to right click, which means clicking on your mouse with your right mouse button, and you're going to find the flatten option down here at the bottom. And when you click that, it's going to make the sticker, and now you can unflatten. So they just don't offer you a flatten option unless you're right clicking. So a lot of people are losing that option and not being able to find it. A lot of options you can find under that right clicking option, including things like bringing to the front, bringing to the back, attach, detach. All of those options are now going to be under this little function. So let me go ahead and unflatten these really quick so I can show you attach. So remember, you used to have attach down here, or maybe it was up here. I don't even remember now, but I think it was down here. But you'll notice you don't have that option here. You have unite, you have slice, you have weld. So if you want to attach these so that for whatever reason they don't move, right click, and you have to use attach from the right click menu. I think this is pretty annoying. I don't want to have to click more times than I need to access these menus. Now let's talk about fonts, because fonts are going to be a little bit different as well. Let me scooch these guys over to the side. And we're going to just open up a text and I'll just put my name here and I'll make this bigger so we can see it. Now, everything's fairly similar as far as like choosing a font, but you'll see that your fonts are right here now instead of over on the left. Your fonts are now to the right of your operation. So I'm going to click on that and you'll see that at the top, everything's the same. Cricut, System, Recent, and Bookmark. But one thing that Cricut changed, they've added these very visual versions of filters so that you're able to kind of get an idea of what they look like. You know, like if you're looking for a sports type font, you can click on that and it'll filter it to fonts that kind of fit that, you know, feel. But you still have your normal filters where you can choose all caps, kerned, multi-layer, writing, all those things. But you also have all of your system fonts that you can use here. And I like that it tells you how many fonts that you have, which is kind of nice. And then you'll see any fonts that you've used recently, plus the one that you're currently using. And then if you have any bookmarked, I don't tend to bookmark my fonts, but all of that's basically the same. But let's say we want to work with our font and we want, let's just choose a random font. I don't care what font it is. So we've used this font, but we want to do some changes to it. Maybe we want to add some offsets. We want to change the letter spacing, things like that. Now up here, you have your sizing with your lock button. So you can change your sizing here. Now the align button is only going to function if you have multiple items selected. So if I want to align these and I just want to center everything, it will only function if I have multiple items selected. Let me get the cat back out of the way. You also have your arrange function, which is the send forward, send back option. And then you still have your typical flips where we can flip our designs. But if you want to do things like ungroup, you can use the right click function here and you'll see that you have the ungroup option. You also have edit text, but under the little pencil is where you're going to find things like your alignment, your letter spacing, your word wrapping, your curve, offset, all of that. And then again, you're going to have all of those combine options that you can use. This is also where you're going to find the ungroup to letters option or lines or layers, depending on what your design or your font looks like. So lots of really not super awful design pieces, but they're just in a different place. So it's a little difficult to find what you're looking for. So again, if I want to add an offset, I can just add it from here. If I want to add another offset, again, I just add it from there. And then you can change the colors of your offset so that you can see them better. Whatever you want to do, but all those offset options are going to be in this function here. Now, again, we can warp our design and you can warp your offsets and you can warp your font so that it matches your offset. So if I select that font, I go to warp and I choose the same. I don't remember which warp I chose. It wasn't that one. It was this one. If I choose those same warps now, you can see that my offset will match my font. It doesn't match perfectly, but we'll have to mess with that a little bit. It could have been just like choose the wrong warp. And then I can just go ahead and undo the warps. So there are a lot more functions here that you can do. I don't know if you can select everything in warp. I haven't tried it yet. You can. Okay, so if you really want everything to match up, select everything and warp it at the same time, and you can do that. Now, the one thing is here, it's all going to be grouped. So if it doesn't line up perfectly, you'll have to kind of select each item and move it. And as you move it, it will rewarp a little bit so that it fits better. So you can see that's a really cool function that they have added, which I do like. However, having to click everything can be kind of annoying. Now, I'm going to show you a quick little design that has multiple layers. So let me get rid of that. I'm just going to go under images. I'm going to grab one that has multiple layers. They're showing me a lot of cats, which is not what I want. Let me go under advanced search and I'm just going to scroll. Actually, this guy, I just used him. So let's add him to our canvas because I know that he's grouped and I want to show you how to group him and ungroup him because it's a little bit different. So let me make him a little bigger. Now what you're going to see is you have this little arrow right here, which is your like layering arrow. It tells you if it has more groups under it. Now again, normally you would have the ungroup option on your layers panel, but you don't. If you right click on the layers panel, you can ungroup it. You can also right click on your design and ungroup it. It's right here. You can also use the shortcut of Shift Control G to ungroup, but that's how you can ungroup things right here. Another thing I want to show you that a lot of people have mentioned to me is they say they only have 2 decimal points. You don't. If you click on this, you'll actually have all 4 decimal points for you to really get your size to exactly what you want it to be. So for some reason you need it to be just a little bit different size. You do still have those decimal points. It just doesn't show as many until you click on it. That's something that I think is really important for you to know just because I think sometimes people don't realize that. So if I want to change this to like, I need it to be 8.52, I don't know, 5623 for whatever reason. He is in fact going to be that size. It's just going to show you 2 decimal points instead of 4 until you click on it. Kind of annoying, but such is what it is. This one here as well, same thing. You still have the lock and all that. So if I want to like change its scale, I can do that. So let's say I want it to be, I don't know, let's go with 33 inches and 0.564. So I can change all of that to fit into, you know, that size by using the little unlock button. Your undo buttons haven't moved. They're all in the same space. I accidentally changed the size of that other ghost. But you can see if I click undo, it'll like resize him, whatever. So all of that's still the same. It's just a lot of like hiding of the functions into places that just mean you have to click more. So again, you can right click. Now you'll notice right now, it's not giving me group or ungroup as an option. If it's doing that and you want out to group things, you have to draw that square around your items. Click and then click group, and now you'll see that I have my group right here. I can also attach them. Doing that, you'll see that everything will change the same color because that means Design Space is going to hold everything together when you hit make. So there are a lot of changes to where things are hiding, but as far as like functionally, they're all going to function the same. They're just in different places. So they may just not be exactly where you think they should be. So that's something you want to think about. If you're looking for something, just kind of look behind stuff. Do the right click on your image and it'll bring up all the different items. They're just a little bit more hidden. Now, if you have any questions about where you're going to find something or if you can't find something, please let me know in those comments down below. I'm always happy to answer those for you. Be sure that you're subscribed here. It's completely free to subscribe. I would love to have you as part of my crafty family here on YouTube. I hope you all have a wonderful day, and as always, happy crafting.